वेलकम टू पॉलिटिकल साइंस क्लास लेसन नंबर 1 पोस्ट वर्ल्ड वॉर पॉलिटिकल डेवलपमेंट पार्ट 3. सो इन द सेकेंड पार्ट वी हैव लर्नड सेकेंड वर्ल्ड वॉर एंड इट्स इफेक्ट्स, कोल्ड वॉर एंड इट्स इफेक्ट्स दैट इज क्रिएशन ऑफ मिलिट्री ऑर्गेनाइजेशन, बाइपोलराइजेशन ऑफ द वर्ल्ड, आर्म रेस, क्रिएशन ऑफ रीजनल ऑर्गेनाइजेशंस, मीनिंग ऑफ नॉन अलाइनमेंट एंड नॉन अलाइंड मूवमेंट. So today we will proceed with evaluation of the non-aligned movement. Evaluation of the non-aligned movement. First, the non-aligned movement has opposed colonialism, imperialism, and racism. So, what was the non-aligned movement actually? What did they follow, or what for they started this movement? The non-aligned movement has opposed colonialism, imperialism, and racism. Colonialism means what? One country's people dominating the other country's people. One country's people dominating the other country's specific area and settling down there. For example, British, Portuguese, French people have their own colonies in the continents of Asia and Africa. Imperialism means domination of an undeveloped nation by a developed nation. For example, India was ruled by British people. So this movement has opposed colonialism, imperialism, and racism. And racism means there should be no discrimination on the basis of color, caste. Number two, it has encouraged and supported peaceful resolution of international disputes. Means any disputes between the two countries would be solved by peaceful means or by negotiations, because it should not disturb the international peace of the country. India led this movement under the guidance of Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru. Number three, the non-aligned movement is based on eternal principles of humanism, global peace, and equality. It has inspired the less developed countries to come together and put forth the problems of poor, undeveloped countries firmly. The aim of this movement is to establish global peace and to give equal status to all countries. For example, developed nations, undeveloped nations, or developing nations. So this was the aim of that movement. Moreover, this movement is based on eternal principles of humanism, means this movement gives more importance to human welfare and well-being. So these intentions behind the movement inspired the less developed countries to come together to put forth their problems to develop their own country. It had more demand of a new international economic order, NIEO, means new international economic order. It has taken a firm stand on disarmament and fostering human rights. It has brought several new streams of economic and social changes into international politics. It gave confidence to developing countries to assert themselves with self-respect in international politics. Here, summarized briefly what we have learned so far, that importance of this movement has not reduced till now, and many changes were brought about in the streams of economic and social life of the people of every country. It gave these countries the confidence to assert themselves with self-respect in international politics, as they have not joined those two blocks, two superpowers. What happened was these countries were now independent. They did not have to depend on other countries. So they had their own self-respect and they got an opportunities to participate in international politics. Next point. End of the Cold War. The Cold War came to an end in 1991 due to the following reasons. The Soviet Union adopted the policy of opening up the economy and loosened control over the economy. Opening up the economy means making available trade globally to all. Soviet Union government, who was following communism. Communism means everything was controlled by government. All the factories, industries were controlled by government. So then President of Soviet Union Mikhail Gorbachev implemented the policies of openness and restructuring and made available trade globally to all. And due to this, control over media was also reduced. Means on the media or newspaper, there was control of government. No one could express their own opinion against the government. But by the adoption of openness, control over media also reduced, and political and economic sphere were restructured. This gave an impetus to democracy. Here we can see Mikhail Gorbachev, then president of the Soviet Union, implemented the policies of perestroika, that means restructuring, and glasnost, openness. Due to these policies, the control over the media was reduced and political and economic spheres were restructured. This gave an impetus to democracy. The countries in East Europe overthrew dictatorial regimes and adopted the capitalism and democracy. The Soviet Union disintegrated and several new nations emerged out of it. Russia was the biggest country. The Wall of Berlin, which divided East and West Germany, was demolished and East and West Germany became one. Then Warsaw Treaty, which was the organization of communist countries founded by Russia against America's NATO Treaty. NATO Treaty means North Atlantic Treaty Organization. That also came to an end. The communist power of East Europe ended the countries in East Europe who joined the group of Soviet Union, that also overthrew dictatorial regimes and adopted the capitalism and democracy. And as a result, many countries which comprises Soviet Union started to be independent and they also adopted democracy. Because of this, Soviet Union disintegrated and several new nations emerged out of it. One of them was Russia, and the Russia was the biggest country. Here we can see post-Cold War world. The following changes came about in world politics after the end of the Cold War. America remained the only superpower in world politics. As I told you, the Cold War came to an end with the disintegration of the Soviet Union, which till then means up to the Cold War, Soviet Union had been a superpower. And afterwards, America remained the only superpowers in the world politics. The conducive atmosphere for the growth in trade and economic relations between and among nations prevailed. There was the free flow of capital, labor, market technology, and information and ideas throughout the world. as most of the countries started to implement the policies of restructuring and openness, a good atmosphere had emerged for the growth of trade. So the economic relations among countries also increased. Because of this, there was free flow of capital. Free flow of capital means, foreign countries started to invest money in India, and today multinational companies are available in India. Today, many engineers, doctors, or high-profile people are getting jobs in foreign countries. We are exchanging technology and information with other countries. All these are because of policy of openness. As all nations of the world decided to give priority to trade relations, the idea of giving aid was replaced by efforts to establish economic relations. The description of opposing nations changed from enemy nation to rival nation. The idea of giving help to others or other countries was set aside. All nations decided to give priority to trade in order to improve the economy. The description of opposing nations changed from enemy nation to rival nation, means there is no longer enmity among the nations. Now only they are competitors of each other. The United Nations now has to take concrete steps to maintain global peace and security. Because now trade had increased globally, every country interrelated to each other. Now they were competitors of each other. So they needed to maintain peace globally. In turn, it was the responsibility of United Nations to take concrete steps to maintain global peace and security. The issues like environmental protection, fostering of human rights, gender equality, and management of natural calamities have acquired a global dimension. Means more importance was given to the protection of environment, for the human welfare and well-being. For gender equality, means there should be no discrimination on the basis of gender. All should get equal rights. For management of natural calamities, means in case of earthquakes, floods, droughts, or pandemic of any disease, in this situation should be managed accordingly. So all these responsibilities were at global level. Now, globalization, the meaning of the globalization. Trade and economic relations among nations became open with the end of Cold War. Means after the Cold War, we can see the trade and economic relations were growing because market and trade was open to all at global level. Revolution in information technology transformed the world. As all the countries started working together, they were sharing ideas, and it resulted into new inventions and new technology had developed, which transformed the world. Number three, the boundaries of nations no longer remained sacrosanct. As all the countries coming together for trade, they were cooperating each other to develop their economy and trade. So boundaries between the nations reduced, and all the countries had friendly relations with each other. There was a free flow of capital, labor, technology, and information. There was a free flow of ideas among the people globally. Economies of different countries are now linked to each other. So we can see all the countries started investing more at global level. Labor was made more available. Marketing was increased for the products at global level, and also information, technology and ideas were shared accordingly. So there was give and take of ideas among people all over the world. All these processes are together called globalization. So because of this, economies of different countries are now linked to each other. So in short, globalization is nothing but sharing of ideas, sharing of your technology, carrying or marketing at a global level and distributing the economy equally all over the world. That is called as globalization, which has brought us benefits. For example, trade increased, economic unification grew, plenty of products became available in the markets, but the gap between the poor and rich nations did not reduce. The benefits of free trade have not reached the poor nations. In this chapter, we studied the global developments from 1945 onwards, means after the Second World War. What developments had taken place? What global changes came about? We understood the world in the Cold War period, the arms race and efforts at disarmament. We also learned about the meaning of globalization. So I hope you understood the lesson. Thank you for watching.